Okay, boys and girls, today we're going to practice using Crayola Model Magic, which is a type of modeling clay. So first we have to open up the package and take it out. Now, you're going to take this and start working it with your hands first, just by squeezing it. And stretching it and get a feel for it and get it flexible. The more you work with it, the warmer it gets, and you'll notice it'll stretch a little further every time. See that? It's getting very elastic now, very stretchy. Now we're going to break this into three separate chunks, okay? So roll a big oval for yourself and break off one and then break off another and try to make them three close to being equal pieces, so they're similar sizes, okay? You can put two of them aside and rest them on your wrapper. And work with one for now. So for the first one, we're going to try just making a simple ball or sphere, which is a fancy geometric word for a ball. And to do that first, I'm just gonna use my fingers like a crab claw, and I'm going to pinch it and turn it. You see how I'm turning it with my pinchy hands. And I'm just trying to shape it kind of into like a rock. So it's like a lumpy ball to start.
Okay.
Once I have that lumpy ball, I'm gonna hold out my one hand like I'm offering a bird some food, like I'm accepting a little gift or holding a little bit of water. And I'm gonna put this lumpy rock of a ball in there. And then I'm gonna take my other hand in the same way. Notice I don't want it flat and open, but curved like a cup. And I'm just gonna roll it over the top. And sometimes I have to open it up a little bit and my bottom hand stays still. And I roll, and I roll, until I have a ball. So it may take you a little longer than it takes me, but roll until you have a nice ball. Number two, you're going to take your second piece, and this time I want you to use your pinchy crab claws to make it longer and skinnier, not too much yet. I'd say thicker than your finger. And now I'm gonna lay it down. And I'm gonna make a snake. I'm gonna use two hands and I'm putting them flat out in front of me with my thumbs tucked in like this. And I roll it back and forth. Now, if your tray is moving too much and you're having a hard time and you wanna work on the table, that's okay. But hopefully your table's clean. We don't wanna pick up dirt. So I'm gonna roll in the middle. Then I'm gonna pick up my hands. I'm gonna roll the left side. Pick up my hands, roll the right side. Pick up my hands, roll the middle. And I wanna keep looking at it. So I'm gonna show you what happens sometimes here. So sometimes this happens, okay? Where it's thick in some spots and really thin in other spots. That happens because we worked too much in those spots and we made them too skinny and we didn't stretch it out the other sides, the other spots. So if that happens, I'm slowly going to try to even it out by rolling more on the other sections like that. And I'm gonna go slow and just try to really balance it out. That's getting a little bit straighter and thinner now.
And see how long I can make it without it breaking. I don't want it to break. I'm gonna make a nice, smooth, even snake. Ta-da!
Now, once you have a good coil or a good snake, you can roll this up in one of two ways. One thing, and I'm gonna cut mine in half and show you both, okay? Because I have a nice long coil here. So one thing I can do is roll it up so it almost looks like either a snail shell or a very fancy lollipop. So what I do is I take one end and I tuck it in and I pinch it like that. And then I keep it rolling inside of itself. And I keep this close to the table so it stays pretty flat. And I gradually twist with my hands and attach it here. So now I used a coil snake technique to make either what could be a lollipop, or I could have not attached one little part here, and I could have a little snail. I can make that stand up if I want, but for right now, your goal is just to explore making that coil. Now with my other one, I can do the same thing, but I could make it grow up instead of just flat on the table. So I'm gonna start my coil, same way. But then I'm gradually gonna feed this end up to the top, a little at a time, just slightly overlapping the one below it, just a little. So now I need like a little cup out of that one, see? So we'll just explore that a little bit. Now for our last technique, we need to start in a similar way to how we started with our ball or our sphere. So first I'm just gonna squish this with my fingers, use my pinchy claws like Mr. Krabs. Squish, 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 squish. Here we go. And now I'm gonna roll a quick little ball. Roll, 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 roll. It doesn't have to be as smooth and as perfect. And now I'm going to make a pinch pot. And to do that, I start by making a thumbprint. So I don't want to stick my thumb straight in like this. I want to use this soft padded part of my thumb right here. So I'm going to push that down. And on the bottom, I'm going to keep a cup in my hand. I'm going to hold a little like I'm holding a water. I'm going to put the ball right in there and use the soft part of my thumb to push down just a little bit. You don't want to go so far that it comes out the other side. This is not great. This is not going to work, okay? So I'm gonna just do that again to show you. Roll, roll, roll. All right, so I'm putting it in my little cupped hand. I'm using the soft padded part of my thumb to push down a little bit. And then I turn it and I hold it and I push my thumb in the other side a little bit, okay? Now it already looks like a little thumbprint. Now I'm gonna use my pincher fingers, so it's like mini Mr. Krabs, little baby crabs. And I'm going to, sometimes I use two fingers, that's just preference. I'm going to put my thumb inside and my finger or fingers outside and just give a little pinch. And then I'm gonna turn it and give a little pinch. And then I'm gonna turn it and give a little pinch. And you don't wanna squeeze it flat. Again, you're just flattening it out a tiny bit. You would like ideally to have this wall be as thick as like the tip of your pinky. Okay, so I'm just turning and pinching, turning and pinching, turning and pinching, pinch, 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 pinch. That's why it's called a pinch pot. So I'm pinching it around, but it looks like a little pot or a little cup like that, okay? That is pretty much it. So that's what you're going to explore today. You can try as many times as we have time for. And at the end of class, since we were just exploring today, we are going to probably be crumpling these up and reusing them next time, okay? Because you can't take the clay home wet, it would have to dry. So we're just going to take it and crumple it. But if you finish early like this and you still have time and you want to try creating things by using the ball and the coil snake and the pinch pot, you certainly can. So for example, I can turn my little pinch pot upside down and then maybe my ball can be a little head, right? And then maybe this can be a little hat. And maybe I'll take some pieces from this and I'll make features on this, make it turn it into something, either an animal or a snowman, or there's lots of things you can do. Think, use your imagination, see what you can come up with, okay? All right, have fun.